In this video, I'll give a quick overview of several software packages you can use for structural equation modeling. These are not all packages you can use, but they are some of the more common ones. And all of them, except for M+, are also free to use. So that's nice, you can use them as well. First up is the Psychonetrics package, which is my own SEM package that I made over the last year and is one of my main topics of research right now. It's an RPEX that does structural equation modeling in combination with network things and time series models and panel data models. And it also now includes Ising model, for example, so not only Gaussian models as well. You can do structural equation modeling in it. For structural equation modeling, it's not the best package that's out there, because it's not dedicated solely to structural equation models, so you can do quite a lot of things in it. And you can do some nice exploratory procedures as well in this package quite easily, a bit more easily than in other packages. But for some other things, some other packages might be better still, like Lavaan does a lot of things that Psychonetrics cannot do yet. For example, like ordinal data methods and a few of the estimators, like robust estimators as well. But I got pretty far already, and I can do quite a lot in this package already. There's this website called psychonetrics.org, and you can look at it, it has a description. And here I'm combining some resources. I also have a blog here where I write some things about it. This I will also be updating as the course goes along. One nice thing about Psychonetrics is also that because I make it, we can change it any way we like. So if you have any suggestions or any ideas about the package or something you would like to see or some functionality you think would be cool, then let me know, we can work on it. And especially also in SEM 2, you'll have time for a project that you can do yourself. And that can really be anything you want. You can teach something to other students, this time probably via video, but that's the topic. But you can also pick to do something in Psychonetrics, for example, and to add a functionality or things like that. Okay, so to give a brief description of what the package looks like in R, here I load the package, and I also load the Lavaan package because we're going to use this Holzinger Swine 4 dataset that's in Lavaan, which is a very simple three-factor model in Lavaan. And the first thing we need to define in Psychonetrics is we need to define the matrix. There's this simple structure that function that makes an easy matrix, but you can also make the matrix yourself using the matrix function. And this matrix is a very simple matrix. It's a 0 if something is constrained to be 0, and a 1 if something is free. And if you use higher integers like 2, 3, 4, 5, then you can specify equality constraints to that. So if I say 2 here, then these would all be the same value. And that's the way that we specify a model. Now all other things are done automatically, so we could also add like the residual variance or latent variances and things like that. We don't have to for the CFA model, so that's easier. Then we use this LVM function called latent variable model. We specify our data set, our expected variance factor loading structure, and which of these items are observed, which are x1 to x9. If we run all this, then we form a model. This is, I think, a bug I still need to fix, so that it gives message, but okay. We form a model, we can print it. There's a nice logo, but now it says it hasn't been run yet, so we need to run it first. I use this pipe operator, but you could also define this like this, if you like it better. And then we have evaluated our model, and then we can look at it, and then we get all kinds of information. So here we have a model fit test statistics, that's a chi-squared statistics I talk about in other video lectures, of 85.31 with 24 degrees of freedom. We can then look at the fit measures, so we get like the error MCA of 0.092, that's not that great, that's pretty bad actually, but doesn't matter now. We can get things like modification indices, and we can get parameter estimates. And then we see here the parameter estimate per matrix. So we see here that automatically we constrain the first factor loading to 1. We can change that with identification argument in the LVM function. And then sigma zeta is the name for psi, and sigma epsilon is the name for theta in psychokinetics. And that's because I started running out of Greek letters, so I used this sigma notation to indicate a variance covariance matrix. One thing I forgot to mention is that you can also make new models in psychokinetics. So let's say here we have the model that we had. We had this modification index here. Let's say we want to free the parameter. We can use the free par function and use the original model to update it. And then we run it again. And then we can use this compare function to compare these two models. And then it will give me a chi-square difference test, AIC, BIC, RMCA. We shouldn't compare models from RMCA, but it will just list it anyway. And the chi-square. Now that's it for psychokinetics. I have another video up that's from last year, where I show a bit more functionality, and there's also more on the website. Okay, the second SEM package I want to talk about is the LaVaan package, which stands for Latent Variable Analysis. And this is a very famous package now in R. It's one of the main SEM packages. So if you learn any package, then learn this one, because you do a lot with it. And it's also very flexible and easy to use. Here's the website, and it has a lot of materials as well. So you can go to the resource here, and there's a lot of books now as well, and videos, tutorials, and things like that. So let's go into R. We can load the data, and we load the LaVaan package. We actually don't need a dplyr. We don't need a dplyr package for this video. Then what we do in LaVaan is we make a model as a character string in R. So this is just a character string, and we can print it. And then we use that in the LaVaan function. Now this is a very long model, and this is the way we would specify the entire model. So these are vector loadings. This is a constraint to one. These are variances, and these are residual variances. Luckily in LaVaan we can make it a lot easier by using the CFA function, which does a lot of stuff automatically. So all this stuff is done automatic, which is kind of nice. So then we're only left with the vector loading structure, and we don't have to specify that this is constrained to one, it's done automatically. So here we have three vectors, and they're indicated by three items each. We use the CFA function to run it, and then we can look at the fit, and then we see the exact same chi-square we saw in psychokinetics, 85.31 or 3006, with 24 degrees of freedom. And then we can do a lot. We can look at the parameter estimates. They're not specified as matrices, they're specified as these operators. We can look at fit measures and modification indices and things like that. And I have another video up from last year where I show more functionality of LaVaan as well. Okay, one thing I forgot to mention is that you can also compare models. So here I ran the first model in LaVaan. I can make a second model here with this cross-loading added that I got from the modification indices, if that makes sense. And now I have a second model and I can compare it. And then you have this really nice ANOVA function in LaVaan that you can use to compare two models. So it will give you the chi-square test of or difference test, and it will give you the AIC, the BIC, and some other information. All right, that's it for LaVaan. Okay, the next package I'll talk about is OpenMX. OpenMX is also a package in R. It's the open source version of an older SEM package called MX. And it's a very powerful package. It's very flexible, which is nice. You can specify a lot of different models with it. It's used a lot as well, but it's also a bit harder to use. So this is the website for it. And here you have a lot of documentations and examples and things. Things like that. And one nice thing about OpenMX is that you can specify your model in matrix terms. So the matrix terms like lambda, psi, lambda transpose plus theta, normally they're hard-coded in the software. But in OpenMX you can change that. And that's one of the main reasons to use OpenMX. Like if you want to do something else, like put a network model in there or something, you can do that, which is really nice. Okay, so let's go to R. This is OpenMX. We can load the R package, and then as you can see, it's already a lot more code than before. We can have the same data set. Then there are two ways to specify a model in OpenMX. One is the path specification, where we are specifying every path individually. And one is the matrix specification, where we're specifying these model matrices. In the path specification, we have to form paths for all these path arrows in the model, basically. So we do it with the MX path function. And this is quite tedious, but it allows us to very flexibly make the model still. So here I'm specifying factor loadings, here I'm specifying latent variance and covariances, here I'm specifying the residual ones here. And if we do all of that and then combine all of that in a model, then we can run the model, and then in the end we can get some parameters. So here I get a chi square of 24 degrees of freedom with which is 85.30 almost. It's a little bit less than in Psychonetics and Levan. I'm not entirely sure why it's a few hundreds of difference, but it's pretty much the same. Now this is the path specification in OpenMax, and it's quite a lot of work. There's this nice package called UMX that makes it a lot simpler because you can actually use Levan syntax for that. So this package here, this code here basically uses the same syntax as before in Levan, but now it runs it via OpenMax in the background, which is nice. It's a different way of getting the same model. So here we get chi square is 85.31 actually. Now it's the same as in Levan as well. So it replicates that. And it gives these nice messages as well about your fit indices. Now finally, the matrix specification in OpenMax that you can see here. Here you have to specify each matrix. So here I specify the lambda matrix and I say which elements are free. So the first factor loadings are false, and all factor loadings that are set to zero are also false. And these are the starting values. And I specify that for the lambda matrix, the psi matrix, and the theta matrix. And now I can specify the expression for sigma. So this I can also change. I can put something else there. And that's really, really powerful. So I can do that. Then I have to say I expect it to be normally distributed. So that's what I say here. And the covariance matrix is called sigma. I'm using maximum likelihood estimation. We put all of that in the model. We run the model. And then we get our output again. And we get our chi square again. And things like that. Like also the fit indices and things like that. So that's OpenMax. It's very powerful. It's also a bit harder to use, especially if you use OpenMax itself and not UMX. Okay, the next software package I want to talk about is JASP. And now we're moving away from R. So these are external programs, even though JASP still behind the scenes or in the background runs R and actually uses Levan. So JASP is an open source program that's designed to be an alternative to SPSS, basically. And it's made by our group, in the Psychological Methods group, in the lab of Erik Jan Wagenmakers. So I'll go to the team here. And it's a big team of people. They're all really nice and good people. Some of you who you will probably know as well if you work here. And they all make this JASP package, which is a very big software program, which contains a ton of analysis. And a really nice thing about JASP is also that because it is made in our group, if you have any ideas about it, then you can just walk to the people, not now, I guess you can mail them, but next year you could walk to the people in the basement and tell them about your ideas. And they're also always looking for students to help out as internships or as thesis projects as well, or students that want to implement things in JASP and things like that. So if you have any ideas or you're interested in working with the people from JASP, then just contact them. Okay, so this is JASP. And in JASP, we can open a CSV file that I saved from R before. So here we have the same data that we have in R. And then we can use the SEM module. That might not be available, then you press here this plus button and you add SEM. We use a SEM module for structural creation modeling. And then this is basically a wrapper around Levan. So here we can enter our Levan model, press Command Enter or Control Enter, and then we run Levan. And then you see here we get the same chi squares as before, same degrees of freedom. We can request other things like additional fit measures and get also the same RMCA here. 0.92, and all kinds of other output as well that we can add to this, which is really nice. Now in JASP, there's also a CFA module now, which is very new. It's made last year, I think, which is under confirmatory factor analysis. And here it's a bit easier to specify these things. So we can say visual for factor one, and then we just drag these indicators there. We add a factor, we can say speed, then we drag these there. And we can say, what was the last one? Textual. And then we can drag these here. And then we get the chi square again and degrees of freedom and exactly the same kind of tables that we had in the SEM module. And here we can also do some other things. You can do a higher order model. I'll talk about that in the fourth week. And we can even make a nice plot of the model that we estimated, which is made with the sample package in R. And that's a very quick overview of CFA modeling in JASP. The next thing I want to talk about is Onyx. Onyx is a free program, open source, that's really cool as well. It's developed in Berlin and in Virginia. And you can download it from this website, which has quite some documentation as well. And this program is very different because it's a graphical program where you just really have to draw the model and then you can estimate the model. So this is Onyx, and as you can see, it's just a complete blank white program with no menu. That's because everything goes via these right-click context menus. So let's first load the data. One easy way to do that is just to drag a CSV file to the Onyx panel. Then we have our dataset here. Then we can start making a model. So let's do that. We double click. We get an unnamed model. We can just give it a name. Model. And we can drag these items here to start drawing them. Now, one thing I like to do is to have the grid here, which makes it a bit easier to make a nice picture. And then we can start placing these any way we want. Let's do that here. Oh. There we go. And then we can start making latent variables by just double clicking. And then we have a latent variable. Let's move everything up. That's nicer. So now we have a latent variable here. Let's make one here as well. Let's make one here as well. Now in this case, we should name them differently because x1 is already used in the variables. Let's call these visual, textual, and speed. And next we can start drawing our model. So we can right click to draw an edge. Then we have our factor loadings. We can do all three. Then we can right click these to free these parameters. And the last one here. Then we can right click with shift to draw covariances. We can make this a bit nicer by drawing this up a bit. And these we also want to free. Then you can see the model is already being estimated as we go along. We can right click to show estimate summary. And then here we have our chi square of 85.3 with 24 degrees of freedom, like we had in the other software as well. Now, a nice trick that I actually only learned yesterday about is that we can also compare models quite easily. One thing we can do is we can first clone the model. I have to look where that option is hidden. Here in Edit, Clone Model. So then we have the same model. And then here I can add like another fact cloning, for example. And now I can actually draw an edge between these two models with a right click to get a model comparison path. And if I hover over here, I see the difference test with 1 degree of freedom and a chi-square difference of 32.9. So that's a really nice way to actually get a picture of what you're doing while you're doing it, which is very useful, especially when you're practicing with SEM and you want to see what you're doing. One thing you can also do in Onyx is to draw a model like this without data. So then you don't draw the data to it, or you don't connect the data to the model. And that's also a really nice way to make a path diagram. So some students before use Onyx solely for path diagram styles. And another nice thing you can do with this is that you can actually generate scripts for other sem packages. Like this will generate a Lavan syntax that you can use in Lavan. And actually I will contact the authors to make try also to get Psychonetics in there. Finally, there's quite some nice things you can do to change the layout or the color. So we can make this happy, and then we have happy colors, which is always a nice thing. Okay, the last package I want to talk about, or program actually, is M+. Now, M+ is not open source, which means it's not free. And also the source code is not openly available, which is sometimes a bit of a shame because you cannot see exactly what M+ does. It costs quite a bit of money, although there's a cheaper student license and there's a free trial version for students. But I think you can only use like up to 6 variables or so in there, so it's not that useful. And the reason I still present M+ is because it is for a very long time the default software in structural equation modeling. It's also the software package that does the most. So it has a lot of different optimizers, some things in there that other packages cannot do. And the makers of that have been the ones also for several decades now that have been coming up with all kinds of new things in structural equation modeling. So if you get really serious into structural equation modeling and you want to use it for your thesis, you might have to use M+ simply because there's no other option in, for example, handling missing data in a multi-level setting or things like that. All right. In the M+ website, there is quite a lot of documentation, which is nice. And also, if you get a license, they're very helpful and they'll answer your questions, which is also nice. In the user guide, there's a ton of examples here online on how to do a lot of things that you want to do. Now, let's first go to R. And that's because R has this nice package called M+ Automation. It can be used to save the data in a way that M+ can read, which makes your life a lot easier. So in this way, this will save a file called Holzinger Schweinfurt 1939.dot. And it gives you also the first part that you need to put into your M+ model when you start using it. And then we can go to M+. M+ looks like this. It's very old school, plain text files as input. And what you do in M+ is you write a text file as input and then you press the run button. And this file I specified like my file location, what the names are of the variables in there. And then I can specify the model in a very similar way as we do in Lavan. That's because the Lavan syntax is based on M+. We specify factor loadings and we use by for that. And we specify variance and covariance with the with command. This at one means that something is fixed to one. And we have to use these semicolons at the end of the line. Now this will run, but we can make our life a bit easier again by simplifying the model, because M+ also does a lot automatically already, like all the other software packages, except for OpenMax. And this model here will give you the exact same result, just like in Lavan, where we say equal tilde sign rather than by. So if you run this, here we go. We get this output file, so it's a plain text file that's saved to your computer. And this is a lot of information. You can request more information to be put in there as well. And then we can find things in here like the error MCA and the chi-square value, which is the exact same value that we've seen in the other software packages as well. Okay, that's it for M+, and that's it actually for all the software packages that I wanted to talk about now.